Nichols has officially become a war zone when Nichols students started the sixth game of Human vs. Zombies, which will continue through November 2nd. Human vs. Zombies is a game of tag that starts at the beginning of the week with all players as humans and one original zombie, or as players call him, the OZ. I walked around campus and talked to some of the humans while they were in their safe zones, and they gave me a couple pointers as to how they tried to survive this epidemic outbreak of the HVZ virus.
Good ways to stay alive are to just keep mobile and pay attention to like the closest entrances around you, and to know all the safe zones to the various entrances of the buildings. So it's good to not commit to just using one entrance, because if you do, then if there are zombies there, then you're screwed and you have to figure a new plan out.
The safe zones, anything is safe if it's inside, or if we see like an orange line like we see right here on the ground. As long as you're inside or in the safe zone, the zombies can't tag you.
Zombies catch most individuals when they are by themselves heading to their vehicles or class. That's why players suggest the best tactic for staying alive the longest is to watch each other's back and travel in groups everywhere you go.
Generally speaking, they usually go in groups. We have some people over there by the quad. We escort people to class. Usually if someone or one of our people have to go to class, we get two or three people to come with them. That way they're not by themselves. Things like that, basically, and now we kind of know where the safe zones are and all that.
Those interested in playing Human vs. Zombies next week should sign up at www.hvzswords.com and locate the Nichols State University game. Students can prep for a new no-go sponsor game during the spring semester called Paranoia. This is Chris Johnson reporting NTW News.